Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My name is Liaquat Zaman and I hope all of you guys are having a wonderful time. Thank you very much for watching this video. This is a series about the noble companions, Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, those who used to live around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today I'm going to be talking about a famous companion who many of you may have heard of. His name is Musab bin Umayr. Musab bin Umayr, one day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is sitting with his Sahaba, his companions, and Musab bin Umayr walks past, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tears began to fall down his blessed cheeks, and the Sahaba radiallahu lowered their gaze, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you know that boy over there, you know that young man, he said, that young man was a person I remember in the streets of Makkah. He used to live a lavish life. He was rich. He was from a well-known family. You know, people used to look up to him. The youngsters, people would look up to him because of his status in that society. You can imagine today that, you know, we have people in society that people look up to, football stars, film actors and actresses, people who are influencers around the world, people look up to them. And imagine Musab ibn Umayr being one of them. And so one day he's living his life, you know, his life of luxury, and he hears about this man in Makkah who is calling people towards a new way of life, a new religion, you can say, that you believe in one Allah, and that you believe that Allah is just, and you believe that mankind should treat each other justly, and people should not abuse one another. And so what happens is, he basically goes and he tries to find out more about this person. Now, in Mecca, just outside of Mecca, where people do the Safa and Marwa Tawaf, the Sa'i, there used to be a house of a famous person known as Arqam. And this house was known as Dar Arqam. So if you actually go there today, you can actually see when you climb the Mount of Safa, they will tell you that this is where the Dar Arqam used to be. So it's a house where secretly Muslims in them days would have to congregate, would have to learn about their religion, try not to tell anyone that they are meeting there. So it was a very difficult time. Musab ibn Umayr is a guy, now he goes there, he visits, he learns about Islam, he learns, and Iman penetrates his heart. You know, it shakes his heart. He realizes that this is the truth. But at the same time, he doesn't want his family, his people to know that he's accepted Islam, because the situation was so volatile. People were so hostile towards Muslims, you know, you can imagine. And so one of the most important things to him was his mother, and his mother, he knew, was a very dominating woman, and she did not want him to become a Muslim. So he secretly is going there, he's meeting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's learning about Islam. Eventually someone sees him praying salat like the Muslims, and news of this now spreads like wildfire, like if a famous celebrity is seen praying salat, and all of this goes viral, people start finding out about this. So Musab ibn Umayr now is known to have accepted Islam. His mother, he goes to his mother, and his mother tells him, have you accepted Islam? And he says, yes, I believe that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is his messenger. So what happens eventually is that his mother now wants to beat him, but at the same time her love for him stops her from doing that. So she ties him, she imprisons him, because the kind of embarrassment and humility that will come upon her and her family when people find out that, you know, one of the most powerful women in Makkah, her son has now become Muslim. What does she do? So she imprisons him. Muslims at that time now were being persecuted. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told about the famous king of Africa in Abyssinia, in Habasha, Najashi. So he tells the Muslims, travel to Africa where there is a just Christian king who will preserve your faith, who will keep you safe. So the Muslims slowly begin to secretly leave Mecca, and they begin, those who can afford it, begin to migrate to Abyssinia, which was known as the first migration. Now Musab ibn Umayr finds out about this, and so he makes a plan. When his parents, when his mother, his family are unaware, he escapes. He joins Muslim travelers and he travels to Abyssinia. After some time, news reaches him that Islam and the people in Mecca have now accepted this faith and everything is now good. So he slowly comes back. And as he comes back, he realizes that this was all a lie. So he goes to his mother, and his mother wants to imprison him again. But he makes it clear to his mother that if anyone tries anything against him, he says he will kill them. And his mother knows how determined Musab ibn Umayr can become. The faith, Iman, belief in Allah, and the most important thing in his life at that time was holding on to this faith, even if it was like holding on to a hot piece of coal. So Musab ibn Umayr, he now lives as a Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or his mother rather, she disowns him, she cuts him off, no more money, no more funding, nothing. So he lives as a poor young man. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he finds out in Medina there are people there who are interested in Islam. And Medina was at that time known as Yathrib. So he sends Musab ibn Umayr to teach the people of Medina about what he's learned so far from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Islam. He travels there. There was a man whose name was Sa'ad bin Zarara. Sa'ad bin Zarara, he was someone who knew Musab bin Umayr, and he took Musab into his protection, which meant that no one in Medina could touch Musab because of Sa'ad's position. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sending him there, he knew that Musab would not be harmed. Musab goes there now and he teaches. He goes house to house. He teaches Islam. He teaches the people. There was a man, his name was Usaid. Usaid bin Hudayr. He later on becomes a Muslim. He is angry. He takes his spear and he goes to Musab ibn Umayr. And he says, "What is this foreign, religion you are teaching us? Leave from this place. Leave us alone." Musab ibn Umayr says, "Wait." He says, "Listen." He says, "I will tell you certain things about my faith. And if it pleases you, you can accept. And if it displeases you," he says, "I will walk away. And I will not say another word." He says, "Fine." So he places his spear in the ground. He sits. And Musab ibn Umayr begins to elaborate about the oneness of Allah, about Islam, about the justice of Allah, about prophets. And the iman penetrates the heart of Usaid. It goes into his heart and it spreads in his body. And he realizes this faith is the faith that he must hold fast to. So he goes. And he goes back to his people and tells his people about the faith. Then later, Usaid comes back to Musab and he says to Musab, he says, "Listen." He says, "There are people in Medina. There are high-ranking people living in Medina." He says, "If you can convince them of this faith," he says, "people will accept it." So he goes and he calls Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, he brings him. And he says to Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, he says, "Sa'd, listen." He says, "This is Musab. Listen to what he has to say." Sa'd listens. And subhanAllah, Sa'd, when iman enters his heart, Sa'd becomes that same person who, on the occasion when he was martyred after the battle of Khandaq, the battle of Ahzab, when he's martyred, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he makes an announcement. He says to everyone, he says, "Allah's arsh, he shook because of the maut, because of the death, limauti Sa'd, because Sa'd died. And it shook out of happiness that Sa'd was now going to meet his Lord." SubhanAllah. This is Sa'd bin Mu'adh. And then he says, "Wait." He says, "I'll bring another person." And he brings Sa'd ibn Ubadah as well. Sa'd ibn Ubadah comes. And he's also a leader of the tribes of the Medina. And Mus'ab explains Islam to him. And subhanAllah, Islam penetrates his heart. And when Sa'd hears, he goes back to his people and he says, "Listen, everyone." He says, "I will not speak to any of you ever again until you people accept the religion of Muhammad." And they accept Islam. And so Medina becomes the hub, and Musab ibn Umayr, subhanAllah, becomes the means of Islam becoming the foundations in Medina. And this is the same Musab that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like I said, when he saw him, tears began to fall down his cheeks. And he said, "This was a man who used to live his life in luxury." And he says, "Now he lives his life and he has patched clothes. He walks in the streets of Medina with patched clothes." Now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw the situation of the Sahaba, but he reminded them that a time will come. He said, "A time will come when you people will be wearing one dress in the morning and you will change your dress and you will be wearing another dress in the evening." He says, "You'll become so rich that you'll be able to eat a variety of foods in one day." And this is promise of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It manifests, it comes true many years later for the Sahaba. Yet Musab ibn Umayr, subhanAllah, this is the same person who lived his life in luxury but gave up everything. Now it's the Battle of Badr. And in the Battle of Badr now, the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they are in a situation where, 313 of them against 1,000 of the people of Quraysh. And they win the battle with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they capture 70 people from Mecca. And amongst those people that they capture from Mecca are the close relatives of many of the Sahaba who have migrated to Medina. And so one day, amongst those captives was a guy called Abu Aziz bin Umayr, who was the brother of Musab ibn Umayr. And he sees him captured there, and Musab ibn Umayr walks by, and Abu Aziz says, "Oh Musab, oh brother," he says, "will you not do anything?" So Musab turns to the other companions and he says, "Listen," he says, "this guy, make sure you tie him tight, make sure you fasten his chains, because his mother is a very wealthy woman." In other words, this is a guy that we can make loads of money off. And Abu Aziz says, "Oh brother, do you say this about your own flesh and blood?" So Musab bin Umayr said, he said, "This is my brother." Meaning that those brothers in faith are stronger than brothers in blood. And this is what Islam should mean to many of us. This is how Islam should come into our hearts. That our Muslim brothers and sisters around the world, wherever they may be, each and every single one of them, they are our brothers and sisters. Each and every single one of them needs to be humanized. We should have feelings of love, of connection, of wanting to help them wherever they may be, whether it's through our own means or through our finances that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted us with. We should try to help them wherever they are. So Musab bin Umayr, he says this about his brother, and he shows this. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a verse of the Quran is revealed about him. مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا أَحَدُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. From amongst the believers, from amongst the Muslims, are those people who were truthful in the promises they made to their Lord Allah. And now, it's the Battle of Uhud. The Muslims are fighting. Musab ibn Umayr is given the honor of holding the flag of the Muslims. And as he holds the flag of the Muslims, an enemy comes and he strikes off one of the hands of Musab ibn Umayr. So he grabs the flag with the other hand. And he's holding the flag and he is repeating the words, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Muhammad is only a messenger. Many before him, many messengers have come before him. He's saying this. He's repeating this. And his arm is cut again. And he holds between his severed arms, he's holding the flag. And as he's holding the flag, someone comes and kills him. And he falls to the ground. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals verses that coincide with what Musab ibn Umayr was saying. وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Muhammad is only a messenger. Many messengers have come before him. If he dies or he is martyred, will you turn on your heels and leave Islam? And whoever turns on their heels and leaves Islam, فَلَنْ يَضُرُ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا. They will not harm Allah a bit. So this is Musab ibn Umayr. He dies. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he weeps when he sees him. And his uncle is also passed away amongst the Muslims who were martyred on that day. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he asks for his body to be buried, they don't find enough cloth for him. If you cover the head, the feet show, and you've cut the feet, the head show. So he told the Sahaba, cover his head and cover his feet with the leaves of the idkhar tree. And when they bury him, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he tells the Sahaba, he says, I bear witness that these people are martyrs for the sake of Allah. And he says, give salam to these people, because these people, until the day of judgment, every time salam is given to them, they will respond to the salam. Musab ibn Umayr, my respected brothers and sisters, a companion, a virtuous person, someone who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he praises in the Quran, someone who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so impressed with, was so pleased with, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the honor of being a companion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be able to understand this, benefit from this, and be able to teach it to our future generations as well. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you for my patrons for supporting this channel. If any of you guys want to support this channel as well, check out the link in the description. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Very much guys for watching this video, and again thank you to all my patrons as well for all your support. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah reward you immensely. If you guys want to become a patron, then links in the description below. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.